Of y'all that are coming in, amen. What a beautiful time and presence of God that we are here in the Lord, amen. And I just really feel the need to pray. We'll be praying, we'll be interceding in the things of God, amen. And you know, we're gonna move forward, amen. We're gonna move forward in the things of God as well. And just being thankful and grateful. Amen. Yesterday's word was so very insightful and impacting. And so my prayer is today that allow the Spirit of the Lord to lead us and to speak to us in such a way that He will just begin to download many things that are portioned and that are even happening in our lives today. So let us pray before we get into the Word of God. Amen. So we thank you, Lord, for today. We thank you, Lord, that it is said by you and by you alone. It is by God and God alone. We thank you, Lord, that it's not by power, it's not by might, but Lord, it is by your Holy Spirit that you have spoken into our lives. Lord, that it is not of we ourselves and what we want, but it is what you want for us. Amen. It is what you are doing in our lives. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And we thank you, Lord, that you're faithful. We thank you, Lord, hallelujah, that you can do so much work in our lives that we can praise your holy name. We thank you, Lord, that you satisfy us, amen, and you satisfy us with the good things, amen, and you satisfy us where we can exalt your holy name, amen. And where we can praise you in so many ways, oh Heavenly Father. I pray that your will be done here today in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you, Lord, for increasing us and blessing us with might and with power and with understanding, Father God, here today. That we walk in the goodness of God. We walk in the blessing of God. We walk in the anointing of God through this anointed word of God. Father, we bless your holy name here today in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. You know, if you're seeing this on a replay, maybe you are doing other things. Hallelujah. I just want to share with you the goodness and the wonder working power of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Once again, it's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by God's Holy Spirit. And you know, that's what the word is leading me here today, in the truthfulness of God's word, is being rooted and grounded in God's love, being rooted and grounded in God's promises, and you know, setting back and seeing, okay, Lord, what is it that you've asked me to do? Because I want to be obedient to that which you have called me to do. I want to eat the goodness of God. I want to receive that of the Lord. I want to be prosperous. Amen. And I want to increase in the things of God. And so as God leads us about our day, amen, just in our daily walks with the Lord, that we can hear what God's voice is speaking and saying. And you know, I just read a small portion of scripture there. Let me see if we can find it again. They're out of the book of Isaiah. And I believe, let's see here. Let me go back, see if I can find that for you. I know usually I have it, everything's already ready. But, you know, the Lord does what he wants to do. Amen. And we're just being obedient unto the Lord. You know, the Lord was talking about to an obstinate nation, you know, one that is, let's say, grabbing a hold of the things of the world versus grabbing a hold of God and what God has spoken. Amen. And what I loved about this scripture, it tells everything that what they are doing and what God is wanting them to say and what God is going to do in their lives. But he also speaks about repentance and arrest. Amen. Because we could see that he is woeing because they're being a children that is not carrying out the plans. You know, the Lord said to them, woe to the obstinate children, declares the Lord, to those who carry out plans that are not mine. In other words, you know, they have their own agenda, they have their own way, they have their own shame, really, because they're doing everything what they want to do. And it was something that I, when I was reading there in verse number 7, where it says that to Egypt, those help in utterly useless, therefore I call her Rahab, the do-nothing, you know. The Rahab, the do-nothing. When we know that Rahab did a lot. Rahab did a lot that helped save the nation of Israel, okay? But then there came a point in time. I know, we're live. Hey, this is live here, amen? We're crossing the borders live here. You see there's an ambulance coming through. But it was through that red scarlet. It was through that bloodline, you know. And we've been talking about having that intimate relationship with the Lord. And if that's where we want to produce life, that's where we want to produce out of the vine. Because, you know, the Lord God is the vine and we are the branches. And the fruit is growing off of those branches. And I'm telling you, if nothing's not rooted, then there's no life that is going to extend unto that fruit, what needs to take place. So we see it says, give us no more visions of what is right. Tell us pleasant things of prophecy of these illusions. Leave this way and get off this path and stop confronting us with the Holy One of Israel. In other words, people just want to hear and hear only what they want to hear. They really don't want to hear the truth. If God is speaking the truth, we must hear the truth. The Word of God speaks about Jesus is the way, Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. And sometimes the enemy will try to thwart us and thinking, well, did God really say? And I'm kind of hatching up, you know, what the Lord had spoken yesterday. But because the Lord is saying a new thing today. But he is still saying, those who have ears, let us listen to the voice of God and to what God is speaking. You know, Rahab got sense to say, okay, I know that my help is not going to come from Egypt. I know that my help isn't going to come from Pharaoh's protection or from Egypt or from anything else besides the Lord. Why? Because she experienced something that she never experienced before. And that's the salvation of herself and her home and of her family and of her loved ones when she extended that lifeline of Christ. Amen. And so she knew that she couldn't go with those that were speaking negative or that were not speaking life into her life. And I believe that's the reason why she said, you know what? I'm not going to do nothing here. I'm not going to do nothing. In other words, I'm not going to move forward on this until I know that this is the voice of God. And this is what blesses me here, because the Lord is saying all these things that he's going to do to a people. But listen to what he says on this end. When he says, this is what the sovereign Lord, the Holy One of Israel says. He says, in repentance and in rest is your salvation. God wants us to go through times of repentance, and God wants us to go through times of rest. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Amen. And, you know, God leads us into the paths of righteousness. Amen. And also too, he lays us down. Amen. He lays us down besides the quiet waters so that he can restore our soul. Amen. And that's out of Psalms 23. We know that he makes me lie down in the green pastures. He leads me besides the quiet waters, and he refreshes my soul because he is guiding me unto these right path. And so there's going to be seasons where there's seasons of repentance. I don't think there's ever should be a time where we feel that as people of God, oh, I got this, you know, and that's it. And never repent and never ask God for forgiveness, you know, consciously, subconsciously, things that we say out of our mouth, things that we're thinking in our minds, and all the words that we say, even before we say them, God knows those things. Don't you think, okay, that there are times that we can be rebellious, or we can be angry, or we could sin against God just by doubting, just by fearing? Is that not sin? God says to be fearful of God, not of men, you know? And so we have to act upon the word of God, and that's repentance. Well, we come before the Lord and we say, Father God, wash me and cleanse me with your precious blood. Allow this word of God to come and wash me. Allow this word of God to come and cleanse me. Let me rest in your bosom. You know what? Like John, he said, you know, let me just rest upon you, Lord. Let me just rest upon you. Let me soak who you are in my life. And that's establishing our lives on the word of God and upon the rock. Rest is your salvation. And check this out. In quietness and trust is your strength. Sometimes we don't like what people are saying. You know, we just got to know how to kind of close the mouth. We got to shut the mouth there. Amen. We got to trust. God is wanting us to trust him, even in the process where maybe you're just always moving at the mouth, moving at the mouth. No, I'm going to stay quiet and I'm going to trust the Lord, and God can move on my behalf. You know, yesterday I was receiving teachings, and the God that fights my battles for me is Gabor, okay? And he will fight my battles for me. You know, and we can call the angels of warfare, the archangels and the warring angels, to fight on our behalves upon this matter. And you know, I don't say that all dreams are for God. Visions, yes, as he gives you the vision. And you have to increase in all those areas and all those ways. And, you know, and see, Lord, is this from you? Are you showing me something? Are you leading me into something? Whatever you're guiding me into do, I don't know what you want to do, but I want to trust you in what you have called me to do. Whatever you're leading me to do, I don't know how it's going to get done. I just know that I have to be obedient in the land. Amen. Because when we take the land, we still got to be obedient to take the land while we're in the land, and see so much strength of God in quietness and trust in the Lord, for that will be our strength. But you will have none of it. Check that out. When we're in disobedience, when we're in lack, or we're slacking, come on now. And it's not that, oh, I have to be doing everything right. No, we just have to do what God has spoken and what God has said. When we do that, we will find repentance and rest, the R&R, and quietness and trust in the Lord. You said, no, we will flee on horses, therefore you will flee. You said, we will ride off on swift horses, therefore your pursuers will be swift. 1,000 will flee, and at the threat of one, at the threat of five, and you will flee away until you are left. Like a flagstaff on a mountaintop, like a banner on a hill. Yet the Lord, even though the Lord is saying, you know what? You're still going to do what you want to do, and you are still going to do whatever, 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 whatever. You know, he's saying, yet the Lord longs to be gracious to you. In other words, where the light was off, we need to turn the light on, and we need to listen to the voice of God. And that's where I'm taking you here today, because that's what the Lord is saying. I need you to listen to what I am speaking in volumes in your life. Can I hear an amen? Yet the Lord longs to be gracious to you. Therefore, he will rise up. God will rise up, and he will show us compassion. For the Lord thy God, he is a just God. And blessed are all those who wait for him. You know, yesterday I was talking to someone. I was ministering way in the wee hours. The Lord's been having me way in the wee hours, praying and interceding. And you know what? We got the calls. We got some call-ins last night. And I was able to help people walk through this little process that's going on in their minds. Amen. And just fill it up with Jesus. And then people call me to encourage me and want to pray for me. Hello. You know, because we all need prayer. Come on now. We all need to increase in the blessedness of our Lord. And I love, you know, when God does that, he just shows up and knows how to bless his people. Yet the Lord longs to be gracious to you, and therefore he will rise up and show you compassion. Why? Because the Lord thy God is gracious, and because he is gracious, we serve a God of justice, and you know, for all those who wait in the Lord. God is showing his people, don't walk the way that you want to walk. Walk the way that I'm showing you to walk. And when you do the walk that I'm showing you to walk in this way, this is the way I want you to walk. And when we begin to walk how the Lord wants us to walk, He will then shift us. He will then move us. He will then lift us up and take us into new places, into new spaces. Look what the Lord says He would do when we will walk in the way that He calls us to walk. The Lord says, then you will desecrate your idols, overlay them with silver, and your images that are covered with gold. You will throw them away like a menstrual cloth and say to them, away with you. Just imagine that. Why did He have to say the menstrual's cloth? You know? And that's because that's nasty, right? That's nasty. But you think of the blood. So there's some type of covenant that you've made with idols or with different things. And sometimes it could be your car. It could be your house. It can be your own self-image. Come on now. Because of what you think. You put your own self on your pedestal. Or maybe you put other people on a pedestal. But God is saying, there's no pedestal here. You got to throw all that away. Amen. And we got to walk where the Lord is causing us to walk. He says, you will throw it away. He says, and He will also send rain for the seed that you sow in the ground. And the food that comes from that land will be rich and plentiful. And in that day, your cattle will graze on the broad meadows. And the oxen and the donkeys that work on the soil will eat the fodder and the mash. And the spread out the fork and the shovel. It says, in the day of the great slaughter, and then the towers will fall. The streams of water will flow on every high mountain and every lofty hill. I'm telling you, God is in this place. Can I hear an amen? The moon will shine like the sun, and even the sunlight will be 7 times brighter, like the light of the 7 full days when the Lord binds up the bruises of His people and He heals the wounds of the afflicted. You know, that reminds me of the 7 candlesticks of the 7 churches of the Lord there in Revelation, where He's telling you, come back to your first love with Jesus. Don't be a church that is idle. Come back into doing the service of the Lord. Come back and do away with devil worshiping. I'm telling you, these are the 7 churches of the 7 candlesticks that God is talking about there in Revelation. We can dissect that a little bit more one day. But the Lord is saying, see the name of the Lord that comes afar with His burning anger, dense clouds of smoke that His lips are full of wrath, and His tongue as a consuming fire. We serve a holy God. We don't serve a iffy God or so-so God. No, we serve a God of a consuming fire. His breath is like a rushing torrent rising up to the neck, that He shakes the nation and the sea of destruction, that He places in the jaws of the people a bit that will lead them astray. But you will sing, and on the night that you celebrate like the holy festival, that your hearts will rejoice as the people playing the pipes as they go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the rock of Israel. I'm telling you, God is changing things around to increase you as you walk in the way, as He has shown you the way, as you go in the way that the Lord has shown you to go. The Lord will cause people to hear His majestic voice. See, God is hiding from you, but not hiding from you enough that He will not be found. Because the Lord says that as you seek Me, you shall find me. And as you knock on that door, God will open up the door for you. And ask. You ask. As you ask, it shall be given unto you. See, there's so much that God wants to do. And as we have asked, and as we have knocked, and as God has opened up the doors, I'm telling you, God is at the door to receive you as you walk in the way of the Lord. See, He will make them see His arm coming down with a raging anger and a consuming fire, with a cloud burst, a thunderstorm, and a hail. And the voice of the Lord will shatter Israel with a rod, that He will strike them down, that every stroke of the Lord lays on him with His punishing club will be the music of the timbrels and the harp, as He fights them and battle with the blows of His arm. Tepeth has long been prepared. It has been made ready for the king. Its fire pit has been made deep and wide with the abundance of fire and wood. The breath of the Lord, like the stream of burning sulfur, sets it ablaze. We have to come back into places of repentance and rest, with quietness and trust in the Lord, so that we may gain that salvation, we may gain that strength from the Lord. And asking the Lord that if there is anywhere that I have forsaken of the way, teach me, thy Lord, thy way, that I may be a student of the Word of God. Lord, you are the master of my life, and I need you to lead me upon the way of righteousness. Let us pray here today. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you have landed us in the land of increase. And Lord, that you are bringing us up into leaps and bounds. And I pray that in the way that you have shown, let your name to be great in everything that we find ourselves to do. All that what we may put our hand to do, may we do it. Not as a service, but of servanthood, which is wonderful and great, but as an intimate relationship with you, that we will not go forward like Moses. I won't do nothing if you don't go with me, Lord. If you don't go with me in this, I will not go up. But as you go, I shall go. As you lead me, so I shall follow. As I seek your face, Lord, you have revealed to me what you would have me to do. Our acts in obedience unto the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Church, God bless you. I'm telling you, I'm unpacking this word of God. I mean, just look at all this here, through devotions, the Bible. I mean, everything, as God opens up and reveals to me His word of His life in my life, amen, and that He leads us along so many steps of the way. I want to thank you, church, for coming in and for being a part of us and with us. Subscribe through all of our social media platforms, especially on our YouTube page. I would love those 1,000 viewers off of my Facebook page, out of my many viewers, to come in on our YouTube. Amen. Let God be God in our lives and to showing us, as He continually to increases us in our every day lives. Let us go to repentant rest, and let us know that God is the truth. Amen. Upon the matter of the many ways that He is revealing His power into our lives. Let us hear what God is speaking. Love you, church. God bless you. Once again, thank you for soaring high with me. I know we're on the shadows here today, but God is great. God is good. And all the time, our God is so very good. We love you, church, and we'll see you next time. Amen. God bless you, church. Hey, be that evangelist in sharing this word of God. Amen. Thank you, speaker family. We love you here today. I want to see you soar, and I'll see you as well. Coming in again, lifting up the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. God bless you, church. Go back into doing what God has led you to do.
Levanta tus manos y clama por el aceite fresco.
Follow in the way of the Lord, and He shall deliver.
Clama por el aceite fresco. Levanta tus manos. Otra vez dile.
Walking
in obedience with her God. Dile, un testigo yo soy de. Decláralo, dile. Con aceite fresco, yo iré. Un testigo yo.